here, children will continue that how it was when she was giving a speech to to the big audience in a vast, means a big hall where many people were there. So it was really, she felt so many world leaders. So it was not where she is speaking to only one, few people. Great leaders of worlds, very famous leaders of world were present over there. So it was really, she has to speak, and when she stood upon the stage, it was daunting, means frightening, fearful, and she was afraid actually what to. Yes, no, because they were all great leaders, and she was just a small girl, but her aim was different. Okay, so but I knew what I wanted to say. Yes, though somewhere inside she was afraid, frightened. Daunting is nothing but frightened, fearful, but somewhere she was confident also. That fear, everybody has it. Yes, because to stand in such big people and to speak, it was not easy thing, anybody could get. But she, what is the confidence part? She knew what she has to speak. She knew what is her aim, what is her goal, why she has been on that stage. It was not the simply they called. She has a purpose. She has been called for some reason, the cause of her life, what she dedicated to fight for someone. Okay. This is your chance, Malala, I said to myself. So to give her confidence, yes, I know my goal. I know what I am here for, and this is my chance. She said to herself, this is your chance, Malala, you have to do it. Only 400 people were sitting around me. So in that vast hall, what she said in front of her, only 400 people. But when I looked out, I imagined millions were. Only in that hall, it was 400 people around her. But when she imagined that I could reach to millions, billions out in the world. So what I'm going to speak, it is not only to these people around me, who are surrounded by me. I am going to speak to the millions out. Whatever I wanted to convey, I can convey now. This is my chance. I did not write my speech with the UN delegates in mind. So normally when you are speaking up, even for your school speech, you prepare first preparation, but she did not. She did not prepare the speech only for the people sitting around, surrounded by her, around her. Only the UN delegates, you can say, no, big guest or speaker, those who have to attend that meeting over there, she did not prepare for them. It was for others, for other people all around the world. I wrote it for every person around the world who could make a difference. See how she made up mind. When you decide that yes, I have to change the world, I have to change people around me. So how you prepare yourself. So here, really people are listening to her. She could have prepared only. No, her speech, she prepared about the people beyond that hall, beyond those who will listen to her, in the whole world who are going to listen to her. So the people, actually people, whoever the speakers, who are the delegates, they are made by the people. Yes or no? So she wanted to make change in the people, not only here. So she prepared what she could say to the people around the world who could make a difference, because they are the real changer. If they change, the whole world is going to change. Yes or no? If now see, in this corona, whatever going on, or lockdown period, whatever our leader, Narendra Modi ji, whatever he said, we listen. We change. We decided, yes, we have to. Because he said we listen, it's not. Because we decided what is the necessary thing needed to be done. And we made the lockdown really successful. And yes, because we are changes. No leader can change us if we don't want to do. So the beginning, they say, no, if you want to change the world, change yourself. If you want to change anybody outside, change yourself at home first. They say, no, the same way, the change begin within us. So she wanted to change the people around the world, where the real change can happen, from where the change would start. people living in poverty, those children forced to work, and those who suffer from terrorism or lack of education. She wanted to reach those children. She wanted the children to hear, those who are really living their life in poverty, they are in very poor condition. Children, those who are fighting with terrorism, every day they have to get up with a bomb sound, fear that today my life, my end. Yes, there are many places in the world around, we are really blessed to have a peaceful surrounding. We are really blessed that we get up every day and go for school. How many of you count that? No, because there are some places, there are children like you who are unable to go to school, unable to live a normal life around. So her voice, her message was to those children she wanted to reach. So who are lack of education? Deep in my heart, I hoped to reach every child who could take courage from my words and stand up for his or her rights. So actually, from inside of her heart, from the bottom of her heart, she prepared to herself to speak to those children, to those ones who are really fighting, to make them great fighters, to take inspiration, courage from her, that when I can do, even, see, I'm like you, I come from a place you live, so stand up for your right, stand and speak up and fight for your right, because right to education is your birthright. You can, if I can fight, you can also. I alone cannot do anything. That was the message she want to send to those million children out in the world who cannot really achieve their education there because of some fear. It's not that they don't want it, they are afraid, they cannot speak. So she wanted to give them inspiration. She wanted to set them an example. Yes, when I can, even you can. That was the message she, who Malala, wanted to give to the children out in the world. I called on the world's leaders to provide free education. Children here, called means when officially you ask some rights. So called on, you are asking to give the rights officially, okay? To some a single person or to a institution or to a group of people. So it is called, I called on the world leaders. So the leaders who are really responsible for the acts, what's going on. So I asked them, what did she ask? To provide free education to every child in the world. So first she demanded to the world leaders sitting there that you must decide to give free education to the children. Let us pick up books and our pens. I said, they are our most powerful weapons. She said, see, fighting doesn't need that you should hold a gun or some weapon. So here, your book and a pen is enough. They are the real weapons. Yes or no? Even if you see, we believe, we Indians believe, what proved in our history, we achieved our independence through non-violence. Yes, many poets, they wrote a beautiful poems inspiring to, with words they inspired people to say no to Britishers. Yes, so here our the best weapon, not only everyone in the world, is a book and a pen can change the world. Yes, nothing but getting education, nothing that having a book and pen can change, nothing but it's that education. How important is education in your life? When you are given education, do accept it. Educate yourself, no matter where you are reading, which school, what stand, what is the thing, what is the language of the stream, nothing, doesn't matter at all. You educate, because education opens up many things, many opportunities. First of all, education makes you a better person, makes you a better human being, where in the world you can know what is wrong, what is right, what as a good human being, what I should do for myself, and also how I can be good for other people outside in the world. That's why she says, one pen, one book. So here she said, they were our most powerful powerful weapons, means very strong weapons what we can take. One child, one teacher, one book and one pen. See the lesson name, one child, one teacher, one book, one pen can change the world. Literally I said one book, one pen, one teacher can change the world. We'll continue, children.